again. Game over. Game over. Game over. Game over. Game over. Again. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Game over. Begin. 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 Line. Game over. Begin. Game over. Again. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Mine. Game over. Again. 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 Mine. Game over.
If I play the game for too long, the shapes and the colors and the patterns just start to become completely meaningless to me, and I start making stupid mistakes. So every now and then I have to alt-tab out and take a breather for a few seconds just to let my mind unravel itself.
Again. Mine. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Mine. Game over. Again. Mine. Game over.
I don't know how well you can hear me. I didn't really test my mic out or anything. But I messed with the settings since last time because it was clipping a lot during Hotline Miami, and I don't know why I didn't mess with it since the last time I streamed. It was all exactly the same, so I don't know what the deal was. But this is Super Hexagon, the new game by Terry Cavanaugh, the guy who made VVVVVV. One of my favorite streams, by the way. If you haven't seen VVVVVV, I recommend everyone go watch it if you can hear me. I can't see the chat room, by the way. It's full screen, and I don't have my netbook set up. This is just a little... Just a lark. Not a serious stream or anything. But this game's cool. I can't stop playing it. It's really, really fun and addictive. Again.
Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over.
Yeah, I wasn't going to stream this game at all, because obviously there's no point in trying to talk while I'm playing. That's not going to work out. Nixel Umbreon says I sound unenthusiastic. I don't know. I'm mellow. I'm not really depressed or anything. I just thought it's a cool game, and I'd like to show people how cool it is. And I can talk, you know, during these little segments when I take a breather. So how's everyone doing? I didn't really talk that much during the Hotline Miami stream. But I think it was a pretty entertaining game in its own right, so I didn't really have to talk a lot. I thought it was an okay stream. Probably crazy that I went that long, but I had fun. I don't know if I'd ever go that long again. It would have to be another really entertaining game.
Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. over again. Game over.
I don't expect anyone to actually watch this, by the way. I mean, it's not really... I mean, it's a pretty basic game. There's not really a lot to it. I mean, you probably get the gist of the game by now, but I don't know. I was playing, and I just thought, what the hell? I'll turn the stream on. There might be someone out there who follows me who hasn't heard of Super Hexagon and who... Who hasn't heard of Super Hexagon and who wants to see what it's all about. So here you go. This is the second set of levels. The first set of levels is just called Hexagon. Difficulty hard. That's the easiest difficulty. And I just barely beat that one. I got just above 60 seconds. And I unlocked Hexagon. Well, I didn't unlock it, but I moved on to Hexagoner. My best time is 43 seconds. As far as I can tell, each level of difficulty has six different segments. Point, line, triangle, square, pentagon, and hexagon. So, you know, roughly 10 seconds apiece, more or less. And I did unlock hyper mode for hexagon. Difficulty hardester. And as you can see, my best time there is 4.11 seconds. Yeah, that's not 4 minutes and 11 seconds. That's 4.11 seconds. So, yeah, not too good at that one. But I figure I'll just move my way down the line here. I haven't tried hardest yet. Hexagonist. And I have two other difficulty levels to unlock. I don't know if I'll ever beat Hexagoner, to be honest. I mean, I'm sure I will sooner or later. If I just keep beating my head against it long enough. I don't know if I'll ever be Hyper Hexagon. That is some crazy shit. I'll show that off in a second.
Again. Line. Game over. Again. Game over again. Game over again. Game over again. Game over again. Line. Game over again. Line. Game over again. Line. Game over again. Line. Game over again. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Line. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over.
I hate it when I realize just a split second too late that I'm about to die and there's nothing I can do to stop it because I moved in the wrong direction at the wrong time. It's a really bad feeling. Then again, you know, going for 40 seconds or so and pulling off a lot of awesome stuff, you feel kind of like a badass. I mean, when I finally was able to go for 60 seconds in Hexagon, it was like, damn, I'm pretty good. Even though, you know, I died 700 billion times. I kind of wish that it gave you, like, a stat screen at the end of beating a difficulty level that shows you, like, how many times you died and your total playtime. I'm sure it would be embarrassing. But, I mean, I've clocked 5 hours in the game so far, playing in little 30-second chunks. And, of course, you know, normally I alt-tab out and, you know, chat or whatever in between, you know, 30-second play sessions. So that's not all in-game time, but it's still pretty impressive.
Again. Game over. Begin. Mine. Flying. Game over. Begin. Game over.
Straight line, Nixil wanted me to tell you that he's getting your messages, and you might not be getting his. Or hers. I don't know. Can you guys see the Steam overlay when I shift tab with the chat window and everything? I'm not really sure if XSplit is picking that up or not. Hopefully not. You don't? Okay, good. I didn't think so, but I was a little worried. Not that there's any, you know, sensitive information in there, but people might not want their Steam names to be broadcast. I don't know.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Game over.
Hey, what's up, Just Drop? Apparently the Twitch chat room is having problems anyway. Which, it's kind of good that I'm not looking at it in that case. Because that would be frustrating. If anyone wants to send me well wishes or words of encouragement, you know, just message me on Steam. My name's Duke of the Bump. Again.
Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over.
Fuck that last one with the little claw thingies. I don't know how else to describe it. The thing that I died on just now, I don't know why I'm having so much trouble getting that. It's like I want to go way too far to the left or right, but that's not a good idea, Nixil says. He hates the obstacle. I agree.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Again. Mine. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over.
That was weird. It's like the key just stuck. But it wasn't the key. It was just that motion. It was stuck moving to the right. Huh. I don't know why that happened.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Game over.
Jestrop says, if I keep withholding my rage, I'm going to turn Super Saiyan, like that black kid. I don't know who he's referring to. His words, not mine. I'm not really withholding my rage. I'm more, I don't know, it's like a Zen experience almost. Like, you just get into a zone with this game. It doesn't really make you mad, because if you die, it doesn't matter, because you've only been playing for 20 seconds and you can immediately restart. I don't know. It's kind of the same thing that I had with VVVVVV. Like, when I was trying to get the, just link me to a YouTube video. I'll have to watch that at my leisure later. But it's like in VVVVVV when you're trying to get the, that one, I forget what it's called, the item where you have to go like up several screens and then back down several screens. It's like I didn't really rage while I was playing that, because the barrier to retry was so low. It's kind of the same thing that Super Meat Boy does. Yeah, the trinket. I don't know why I could not think of that word. But also the name of that specific corridor. It's been a while. Nixil reminded me that it's called a trinket. Alright, just a few more dozen tries, and then I'll show off Hyper Hexagon. Yes, doing things the hard way. Thank you, Nixil.
Again. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Line. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Game over.
You see what I said about stupid mistakes? Okay, I'm gonna watch this YouTube video and try to calm down for a second. This game, man, if you want, you can play the free version. Just Google Hexagon Distractionware, and it's in Flash, and it's pretty similar to the Hexagon level of Super Hexagon, but it'll give you a feel for whether you like this kind of game or not. But if you do like Hexagon on the website, it's definitely worth the $3 for Super Hexagon, because playing it full screen is just such a head trip. Like, you know the Tetris effect? How if you play Tetris for long enough, you just start seeing Tetris pieces everywhere, and you dream about Tetris pieces, and it invades your subconscious. I get that with this game, like, really badly. Okay, this is a long video, so I'll watch it later. But let me just... Justroff says I get that with porn. Oh, wow. Okay. Deep breaths. Begin.
Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Game over.
Ah, so close. Such a dumb mistake I made right at the end. This is one of the few games where the longer I play, I genuinely feel like I'm actively getting better at the game. Like, I can feel, you know, my reflexes improving, and I start reacting to the game just, you know, on a subconscious level. You really get into the zone with this game. Like, if you've ever played like Rock Band or Guitar Hero or something, it's the same kind of zone that you get into in that game, where you just kind of like zone out, but you do really well at the game. Like, it just kind of comes naturally to you. Like, especially when I'm drumming, like, I'll just get into a zone and I'm like, oh my god, how am I doing this? And then I start thinking about it and I start screwing up. It's kind of the same thing with this game. The lesson is, don't think.
Begin. Line. Client. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Again. Game over.
It's the same kind of zone you get into when you play like a bullet hell shooter. Like, this game gives me the exact same feeling that playing like Death Smiles or something does. Like, the patterns just start burning themselves into my brain, and then eventually I can get it just like through muscle memory. Nixel says, when I get a chance, I should show us how the hexagon and hyper hexagon modes can change shape. Oh yeah, this level doesn't really change shape that much. Well, at all, really. But in the main hexagon mode, the middle shape actually changes from a hexagon to like a pentagon and a square. And that can really mess with you. Actually, let me do, I'll try just plain old hexagon real quick and see how well I do. The one that I supposedly beat.
Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Line. Triangle. 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 Game over.
So yeah, you can see how the shape change can kind of mess with you until you get used to it. I'm actually surprised I'm doing as well as I am, but after Hexagon-er, this one seems downright slow. I just thought that after I got used to the patterns of Hexagon-er, it'd be hard to go back to just normal Hexagon, but I'm not doing that bad. Nixel says, Hexagon-er and Gonest and their hyper modes never change from hexagon shape. That's kind of disappointing. You might have also noticed that, like, occasionally the perspective will change in this one, which was really hard for me to deal with when I first started playing. It just totally blew my mind. Like I don't know, like it'll skew, like you're looking down at everything at an angle, but then it'll change back pretty quickly. It's weird. I'll do this a couple more times and see if I can actually beat my old score. Probably not, but I'm not doing that bad.
Begin. Line. Triangle. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over.
See, that was one instance where the perspective change kind of messed with me, because I thought I was further over than I was. So, take some getting used to. And another thing I like about Hexagoner more than this level, is that the contrast between the shapes and the background is a lot starker in Hexagoner, and occasionally, like, the shapes in the background are close enough in color that can mess with you a little bit, too. But I guess it's just another part of the game. I did pretty well there for a sec. I almost hit a minute. I got pretty close.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Triangle. Square. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Line. Triangle. Game over. Begin. Line. Triangle. Pentagon. Hexagon. Excellent. Game over.
All right, well, I feel accomplished. I beat my old record by almost 2 seconds. All right, well, that's basic Hexagon. It's pretty good. Okay, here's Hyper Hexagon. And I've only played this a couple times, so I'm not going to spend too much time on this, but just as a little demonstration.
Begin. Game over. 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 Begin. Excellent. Game over. Begin. 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 Excellent. Mine. Game over.
Wow. I feel pretty good about that run. That's better than I thought I was going to do. So yeah, it's Hexagon, but super insanely fast and hard and stupid. And I'm not going to mess with that anymore. Alright, Hexagoner. Gotta give it the old college try at least a few more times.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Flying. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Game over.
That is my least favorite obstacle in any of the levels so far. I don't know why I have so much trouble with that. It's like, I'm not mad at myself. I'm just disappointed. That's all. Come on, Duke. Get your head in the game. The big esports championship is on the line. You don't want the opposing team to take the trophy. Or something.
Again. Mine. Game over. Again. Game over.
Nixel says, you don't want to go into the far sections of the hexagon on the obstacle. And it's like, yeah, I know that. My brain knows that. But my fingers just want to do their own thing. They're like, I can't. Ugh. It's hard. Stupid fingers.
Again. Mine. Game over.
Kostya asked how you control the pointer. It depends. I'm using the keyboard, so it's just the left and right arrow keys. If you can also use the mouse, the left and right mouse button, or you can plug in a controller, in which case I think the default is the shoulder buttons, like on a 360 controller, either the bumpers or the triggers. This game's also available on iOS, and honestly, I can't imagine playing this game on an iPhone, just on such a tiny screen. It seems like it would be, I don't know, an obstacle. It might be easier on the iPad, but on iOS, I assume you just touch whatever side of the screen. Nixel says, I play it on my phone, it is hard. And yet, he has kicked this game's ass three ways to Sunday compared to how I've done so far. Especially since your fingers get in the way, yeah? Yeah, I can't imagine it. I have to say, though, playing on... I have my computer connected to a TV, and I sit at my desk in front of the TV, and it's pretty big. And it is an experience. It's like you're immersed in this psychedelic wonderland. It's pretty awesome.
Again. Mine. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Game over again. time. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over.
One 100th of a second of matching my old best score. And that's just 2 seconds away of getting the next level. Just 2 seconds. 1/60th of a second. Yeah, I guess that's right. I thought it was tenths and hundreds, hundredths.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. 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 Mine. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Mine. Game over. Begin. Game over.
See, I almost had it that time. Whenever I hit that obstacle, I either want to go too far or not far enough. I just can't hit the happy medium, and I always end up hitting something. Oy.
Begin. Line. Game over.
Nixel has informed me that the music is available on Bandcamp, so check that out if you like the music. Just Google Hexagon Bandcamp and you'll probably find it.
Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Game over. Again. Line. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Line. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Line. Square. Game over. Begin. Game over. Begin. Game over.
All right, well, I guess that's probably enough for tonight. I was hoping I'd at least be able to beat my old score on Hexagoner. But I beat my old score on Hexagon, so I at least accomplished something. This game's $2.99 on Steam, probably a similar price on iOS. It's pretty good. I like it a lot. Hope you've enjoyed this look at the game, and keep watching the Facebook and the Twitter, and subscribe on Twitch.tv. You know, if you subscribe on Twitch.tv, you get an email anytime I go live. You have to, like, verify your email address, but yeah, that's a good way of keeping abreast of current events, and I'll see you guys soon. Later.